Greetings and welcome to another edition of Berks Perspectives. I'm Chuck Gallagher. And with me today are three people who are just simmering with news and the heat. Mary Ellen Mahan.
Hi, Chuck.
How warm are you?
It's very nice here in the studios.
The air conditioning is wonderful. Fred Levering, you never have a bad day, even if it's this hot.
And especially now, I can go up to the Poconos and get a six-pack at the gas station for Memorial Day.
You don't have to go to the Poconos. You can go to Schuylkill County. It's even closer.
Well, now we're talking.
You were saving gas now, too.
That's Monoy City.
Or you could go to the beer distributor, which is even closer.
Right. I don't know if they'll break up a case now. They won't.
You can get 12
packs. Yeah, you can get 12 packs.
12 packs, okay. You're both very learned when it comes to that particular thing. And Fred Opalinski.
Hi, Chuck. We're having a heat wave.
A tropical heat wave. The temperature's rising, the ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta.
That's right.
That's a song from something.
We could sing it as a trio.
Well, you could indeed, yes.
Watching this show.
Let's take a look at some of the things that are occurring locally. First of all, City Council has approved the new police chief and the new city manager. Seems like two very good choices from our vantage point on the outside.
And how refreshing to see unanimous votes from the council.
That'd be interesting.
That was the case with both of them.
Yeah, 7-0 both. It'd be interesting to go back and see when the last time that occurred.
Yeah. In agreement with the mayor.
Right.
That was my first reaction. Surprised that it was unanimous. And second, the fact that both gentlemen seemed to be extremely qualified. I think there was the only negative or constructive criticism I heard was from Donna Reed, who wanted to have the search be a little bit broader. But I don't think there's any disputing whether or not the candidates in question are solid candidates for the job. I just hope that both of them are roaring success in their new jobs.
I hope so, too. I hope it's a portent of good things to come.
Yeah. I don't mean to be negative, but the chief is from around here, which is a good thing, but has worked most recently, I believe, with the Secret Service.
So 20-some years of Secret
Service. I would have kind of preferred that somebody that ran a big police department, but...
Well, he created the police department in Bruckarest. Well, he went over and trained the cops and got them all going and set up the force, which is not Reading, I'll grant you, but, you know, Bruckarest could be the same as Reading. We'll hopefully find out.
We're about to find out.
Hopefully their crime rate will be a lot lower than ours. But I do think it was, as you all point out, the 7-0 vote was nice to see. Also, they've talked about possibly getting away from the water authority and turning the purse strings over to the city.
Well, I think the logic there. They talked about drowning the water authority, right? I mean, it's not just getting away from it, dissolving it.
Well, they want to dissolve it and run it themselves.
Did you say drowning the water authority?
Yeah, I was going to do it. That was a chuckster.
Now I'll be asphyxiated for the rest of the program.
Well, there seems to be some question, I guess, procedurally as to whether or not the city needs to take on the $95 million of debt that they have, the authority has, before they can so-called dissolve the water authority. So we'll see how that plays out.
Well, they'll probably just transfer the debt somewhere.
Well, it's not going to go away.
No, it'll be transferred, I would imagine. I think the logic is, if there is logic behind it, that this way the city will have control over it and they're not going to sell off their major asset, which is about the major way of the income for the city right now. I think the water authority is turning over about $10, $11 million a year to the city.
Yep.
So that's an appreciable.
But in all honesty, there really needs to be some independence in an organization like that. I mean, they have a big responsibility for public health and so on and so forth, but you just worry. I mean, the city, part of the city's financial problem has been the result of the water authority and the sewer plant monies that are generated going into the general fund instead of being dedicated to those systems for improvements and upgrades as well as providing the service. And having an authority just keeps it a little bit apart, you know. I mean, mm-hmm. It's just...
Yeah, I hope it doesn't become sort of too easy a source of cash with short-term...
Well, I think the fear, too, was that the authority would sell off the water authority. They would sell it to a private individual or something like that with a 30-year lease, and at the end of 30 years, you would have nothing. I mean, that initial flow of cash is nice. That's a very tempting offer. But at the same time, you got to look down the road what's going to be there.
Well, and it's a complicated business. You really need people that know what they're doing to be running. And that's not to say the city doesn't have it, but it isn't just, oh, we'll take this over because it's a nice cash cow. And I'm hoping that that this is well thought through and we get the right people in place to manage it. And
well, again, the new managing director has some experience with that from Easton, although it's a much smaller facility, their sewer situation.
Well, the other angle that I found interesting, and, you know, Fred, you used the words about, you know, you need to have some separation. And I found it interesting that there's no proof, but that there was a question as to whether or not there was any conflict of interest with a couple people who I guess are on the authority with their firms receiving contracts. That has been dealt with.
I mean, before it was didn't look so good, but that was with the solicitor and the director's company basically running a lot of the day-to-day stuff. And there seemed to be a conflict there, but that was separated a couple of months ago.
Yeah, the appearance was resolved.
Got rid of that, but I just like seeing some separation, and I like seeing the authority not on the front page of the B section of the newspaper. I mean, the best authorities, in my view, are the ones you never hear of because they just quietly do their job instead of being embroiled in some of these other shenanigans. So.
Well, I hope that the level of customer service that they provide goes up, because dealing with their agents, having had that wonderful opportunity, was less than desirable. And I think there's also, I don't live in Reading, so I can't, I went and tried to look at the history of rate increases, but what, at the end of 2014, they had approved a 21% rate increase that hit homeowners at about 13%. So everything that I could find online was all about people complaining about, you know, just constant rate increases.
When we moved here, our water bill tripled. I mean, we moved here from Western Pennsylvania. And I couldn't believe that what we were paying quarterly was our monthly bill here. And it is, I think, pretty expensive. And I hope it does not skyrocket now. But
well, I think there was a comparative analysis of other cities, too. And I think we are, Reading is pretty much ahead of everybody else in terms of charge. Yes. But there's also a push now for IDs for undocumented people, not necessarily undocumented, but people who don't have IDs. Your great-grandmother, for example, or maybe your 14-year-old who hasn't gotten a license, so they want to get IDs for people. Do you have any feelings about identification?
Well, doesn't the state give IDs, not give, sell for $10, I think. I think you can get a state ID for $10. I don't know what this adds that isn't there otherwise, or were they looking to make this free of charge?
I think that's what they were looking at, a freebie.
I wonder if it's not associated with the whole debate that's been going on for years about undocumented aliens. And like, because this came up with the whole the Homeland Security, what was that out of Berksheim, where there's the question about if you don't have an ID, you can't get a driver's license, and you can't get a driver's license if you're not an American citizen. So it's kind of like this conundrum. And I was reading stories about how people who were part of the demonstrations that I guess occurred in Philadelphia this past week, that they had one of the guys had a son who was stopped while he was driving and could not produce a license. And he was deported because he was not an American citizen. So you've got people who come to America illegally, and you basically have people that I would say fall into two camps. One, that they obviously would not have left their, you hope that they would not have left their country unless they were trying to advance themselves and come in here legally. But if they came in illegally, are they trying to get citizenship or not? And if they are, then I know my bleeding heart leftist heart. You know, bleeding leftist heart wants to make, you know, help those people and give them some form of an ID.
You mean you have some heart left?
Yes. All right. I'm going to show very little of it for the rest of the show now to you. Okay. But you've got people who come in here just to work who may not be the best of the citizenry of the world. And I'd like to make sure that they don't have IDs, because what else can a driver's license get you? So, I don't know. I also think it's part of the, let's go make sure everybody's got an ID to vote.
Well, I was thinking that it maybe was anticipating the votes, and if we need to
have
ideas. Well,
they can't vote if they're not citizens.
Right. Oh, that's right. Yeah. Well, this didn't say, I mean, maybe they didn't read it carefully
enough.
These
are people who just don't have IDs.
Who don't have IDs, and so then who don't have driver's licenses.
The inference clearly is that it's the illegal immigrants, because they said about that famous quote about coming out of the shadows. I mean, you know, it's the only reason you're in the shadows is because you don't want to be found. I mean, there's just an enormous difference between legal and illegal immigration. I think all four of us would very clearly be in favor of immigration. I mean, all of our families came from somewhere, and there's nothing wrong with that. As I've said before, I've always taken a lot of pride in the fact that I haven't heard of a boatload of people going to Cuba. I mean, they want to come here. This is the place for opportunity.
There are big boatloads of people going to Cuba right now.
Well, but that's different.
It says Disney on the small staff.
The point is simply that there's wonderful opportunities here, but do it legally. I mean, this,
we need to reform the whole immigration system. I mean,
Well, that leads right into the detention center. Families that were being retained for God knows how long because they are here illegally. They don't have, so do we keep them, mothers and children, locked up, essentially? I mean, they are basically incarcerated.
Well, I don't know the answer to this, so I'll show my ignorance here, but it says that it's a secure facility on the signs as you drive in, because I go up there every month because it's where the library system's headquarters is. And they say that people are free to leave anytime they want, and yet there's lovely fences and alarms and everything. I've never read a story in the Eagle about anybody ever leaving there. Are people, in fact, free to leave?
I don't know, but if they were, where would they go? If they're here illegally, they have no one to report to other than where they are.
I don't know if that's true. Some of them may have family here. But I'm assuming
it's
not.
If they do, I can't imagine why they're being retained then or detained. It's a quizzical thing.
Well, these are folks that were here illegally, right, and they were somehow caught and needed to go somewhere as the legal process unfolds. We had space because of the new Berks Heim being built, and there was the old one. And the county commissioners cut a deal with the feds to house these folks. The county's paid for it, so it actually is a profit center.
Right, it is a profit center.
For the county. The county commissioners have told me that they are inspected regularly by state authorities who have always given it high marks as a well-run, clean, et cetera, facility.
Has anyone
the agitation just seems to be from folks that think that they shouldn't be detained.
But why detain them for so long?
Should just be given an ID card, I guess. But I don't know.
They've been detained for such a long period of time.
No, but that's the legal
process. Just because of the way the system goes.
Process, yeah. Right?
Well, this will come to a head in February because that's when Pennsylvania is not going to license it anymore. Apparently, it's licensed by the state as a children's center, not a family center. So the state has advised them that their contract will be up, or their license to operate will be up in February.
And again, locally with the city, the education center of the ILEAD charter school had its ticket pulled by the school board. Evidently, the grades were not up to standard, and the school board pulled the ticket. The ILEAD people say they're going to fight it to the highest court. And it's, what are we talking about, 500 students, I believe? That's a big chunk out of the school district.
Yeah, and they were kids that are there because they were having some issues of one sort or another. So taking them and absorbing them into the mainstream classrooms is not going to be an easy thing.
No, but I think the school board's taking that into consideration.
I would hope.
I think funding may be a factor, too.
Oh, yeah. Well, and I have to wonder what the real motivation was, and I suspect that it may have had to do more with funding than with test scores.
You mean from the school board's point of view?
From the school board's point of view, because that money's going to ILEAD, not to the school district.
Right.
I'm generally not, like, a wild fan about charter schools, but I've had a fair amount of interaction with folks from ILEAD. Every year we would have classes, when I was at Trinity, social study classes coming to the church for a tour to talk about the German immigrants and the history of the church, and those kids were extraordinarily attentive and had wonderful questions, and I always enjoyed seeing them. And the social studies teacher seemed to me to be a real super guy. And that happened for about three or four years, I think. And I knew some of the folks in the administration there who had good things to say about it. So I think there is an element of the student population. It was originally set up, I think, for kids who either were recent dropouts or likely to be dropouts. Mm-hmm. And they were looking at perhaps 200 students. That that greatly expanded and went beyond that narrow category to kids who were afraid to be at the middle school or, you know, for a variety of other reasons other than being older and dropping out. So it seems to me that it was meeting needs and that weren't maybe being met as well in the public schools.
I think it would have been interesting if the decision or the arbitrator to decide whether or not they kept their charter was if it was not the school board, because you got to question the...
It's hard to think of that being impartial.
Yeah. I mean, it's obvious that if there are kids who are dropping out or look like they're going to be dropouts, if there's an intervention that can take place to prevent that, that is wonderful. But is it successful enough? I don't know. I when I hear about charter schools, I have a lot of friends who are in education. And I kind of equate charter schools to the distance education, like for college degrees and graduate degrees. There are some that are very good, and there are some that have popped up simply to make a buck.
Sure.
So, and I don't know where to classify ILEAD because I don't know enough about the school, but I would hope that there is some option that would allow for that spillover for the kids that could be in trouble within Reading. So it'll be interesting to see how this plays
they
out.
They still have GED programs, don't they? I think RAC has a GED program offer, which is the equivalency degree. So to have a school set up for that purpose alone seems almost a little redundant. If the RAC program is successful, I would trust that you pass the test or you don't pass the test.
Well, and RAC also has some extraordinary relationships with industry
within
the area in terms of getting kids jobs.
Right.
So,
well, they're going to appeal it, so we'll see what happens if it's...
On a positive note regarding the Reading School District again, the Why Not Awards, if you all are familiar with the Why Not Awards, they're given out. It's Tony spelled backward, the Tony Awards for Broadway shows, and they've called it the Why Not. And each year they get some judges to come in and look at the musicals at the different high schools and pick the best. And Reading High came away with 9.
I was so thrilled to see that. I sent Jeanette D'Angelo an email this morning and said, your buttons must be bursting with pride. Because to see that level of achievement is just a marvelous thing. And
using an opera as the basis, Aida is the one that garnered all the awards. And I don't know how many operas or how many rock shows have been based on operas. And with that success.
Yeah.
Name just one other.
I can't. let's see. No, Madame Yes, I can. Madame Butterfly, this Miss Saigon.
Yeah, well, and West Side Story was Romeo and Juliet.
Romeo and Juliet,
but that's opera. That's
not an opera, but we'll give you the... You're close. You're close.
They sang in it.
Yes. Not in Romeo and Juliet, but...
Yeah, but what a terrific thing for those kids. It's great.
On another local note, quasi-local note, the governor just signed a bill in which various gasoline stations, I guess Wawa, Sheets, places like that, are able to sell 6-packs of beer now. I guess 2 6-packs to a customer until they go around the block and drop in again for...
9 stations in the state of Pennsylvania, is that right? That are allowed to do that, so...
It's a minimal...
Look hard to find one.
It's an attempt to loosen things up a little bit, and I think the individuals who sell beer, well, the distributors are not happy about that, I wouldn't think. Again, on a positive note, Asad Imelzuki, the founder of the Muslim Center and also the owner of the Queen City Diner, and Steve, as he's been called, has done some wonderful things for the community. He's constantly giving all his time and effort to the less well-off, shall we say. And it's nice to see him having set that center up and watched it succeed, watched the Muslim community grow. Now he's stepping away.
Passing the torch, yeah.
Yeah.
He's been very active in the World Affairs Council as well.
Right.
And I know him only because he's in my precinct, so he comes in to vote all the time. And I have to admit that, I hope I'm not saying anything I shouldn't say, but he comes in, he wants to know whether or not his family has voted. And
he's checking up on them.
That man takes voting more seriously than anyone else I have ever met in my entire life, and he is an example to what Americans should do with their right to vote.
He is so devoted to making this a better place, and lots of people have been blessed by it.
Well, this is not a segue by any means. It just happens that Steve is Egyptian, but we're taking the news now with the Egyptian airline and the crash in the Mediterranean. There hasn't been anything coming about recently over the last couple of days, in terms, especially in terms of finding the black box, to find out just what brought that plane down.
And I heard somebody say that there are all kinds of ways that the black boxes, I mean, there are black boxes that can be automatically floated, you know, if they're in water and float to the surface. There can be black boxes that, I mean, the technology is there to have them broadcasting continuously the information, so you don't ever need to find them because all of that stuff is a matter of record. And yet the airline industry is doing nothing to implement that. You know, so we've got to search in 2 mile or 3 mile deep water.
You've got a 30-day expiration.
Yeah, on the battery. Yeah. Right. So why we're using technology from the 60s essentially, rather than with something this critical, why we wouldn't just improve the technology and not have to deal with all of this mystery.
Now this is a segue.
It's baffling.
This is a segue. TSA, the lines at the airports, hours on end, waiting and waiting and waiting. You ask why they haven't updated the black boxes. Why haven't they paid attention to what's being done with the TSA?
That coverage has been absolutely fascinating to me because you basically, depending upon what position you want to take, it's either because they're not staffed correctly or the number of passengers have gone up. Then you add in the trifecta of, you know, of negative influences, which is, so the passengers are up, they don't have enough people, and they've also changed the criteria that they use because some of the tests had allowed people to sneak things past the checkpoints that they shouldn't have.
Like 97% of the contraband went through that was in the test thing. Yeah. I mean, that was pretty awful.
And so that you read that, well, okay, so the organization or the administration's not managing this correctly. And then you see, well, they haven't gotten the funding. And I don't know the true story behind it, but somebody's not watching the ship or at least making it visible. And now that we've got Memorial Day coming up, I feel sorry for anybody who's getting on a plane this weekend or in the next couple weeks.
Well, by mid-June, they're supposed to have added 200 new folks to the staffing, which should help.
And I guess some people were hypothesizing that going private would allow them to...
Some airports have done that.
Yeah, and they still have lines.
Right, yeah, it doesn't seem to have improved. Well, it's not a happy story. I'm glad I'm not leading it up.
I'm driving.
You're driving.
I'll go past those gas stations at 11.
Another bit of news that is not on the lighter side by any means, but Mr. Cosby's hearing, he's been... ordered held for trial. Now, a preliminary hearing, all they have to do is establish a prima facie case, meaning that a crime did occur, in order for it to move on. So the hearing really does not give you a great deal of information as to what went on from the prosecution standpoint or the defense standpoint. Anything there? I summed it all up.
That's about it.
Okay. She was given pills. She admits she took pills. He admits he gave her pills.
And it goes from there, though. There are other things, other factors. It'll be interesting to see what comes out because of all the women who have come forward and said that he did, in fact, abuse them. This will add some credibility to those, I would think.
Yeah, with all of those women, I don't know how he was making TV shows. But
he claimed what he gave her was Benadryl or something like that, as opposed to Quaaludes.
She was itchy
or something. So. Yeah. I had a rash.
I don't think his efforts to scratch were what she had in mind.
Oh, dear.
Oh, indeed. Indeed.
How much time have we got left?
I think basically, on the Democratic ticket for president now, let's assume that Mrs. Clinton does get in, but Mr. Sanders has made some very strong moves in terms of getting a piece of the platform. I think there's going to be about, four or five seats that Bernie's going to have in there.
Five.
So there will be some burn.
Well, and I think it makes sense. I mean, who a year ago would ever have imagined that he would get the kind of notoriety and support? So I'm hoping the Democratic Party will listen to what he's got to say.
Well, he gets five, Clinton gets six, and the chairman of the Democratic gets to give another six. So I think it's wonderful because the division that is occurring within the Democrats with, you know, it's Bernie or bust type thing, it's probably the best thing the Democrats can do to try to unite the party.
And then, of course, if Mrs. Clinton is found guilty of a crime by the FBI, that throws the whole thing up in the air even further.
Well, that'll be interesting since she wouldn't be the first person in that job title who apparently was not using the server correctly for mail.
No, I think the Attorney General's, the Inspector General's look at the situation, found that she did, in fact, misuse her office, but not in a sense of it being a crime. It was kind of, I guess, her predecessor, Mr. Powell, also had done the same thing. So, but as one person pointed out, just because he did it doesn't mean what she did made it right. But there, it doesn't fall into the statute of being a crime at this point. And I think another facet with Mr. Sanders, Mr. Trump and he may debate. There's a possibility the two of them could get together, and that would probably be a boon to any network that wanted to pick it up. It could be Seinfeld and all the other comedy shows put together in 1 hour and a half or whatever. I think it would be the light.
I'm not sure that I'm going to watch it if it comes to pass, but anyway, I'll hear the sound bites.
And I want to close. Who can get redder in the face?
I want to close. Well, redder in the face, I think Donald has the advantage there. But I think it's interesting to see that the NFL, National Football League, may have had some efforts to make things unclear as to football injuries. They may have put some pressure on here or there to make sure that people didn't come out and say, hey, yeah, football is in fact a dangerous sport.
Does that surprise anybody?
No, I guess not. I guess that's the nature of the beast we live with. Mm-hmm.
And if anybody doubts it, I just personally think that revoking their no holds, no strings barred, what, $30-something million commitment that they had given, and
right.
just revoking that because the study wasn't going to be done by who they wanted to have it done by, I think it goes back to our earlier conversations about, you know, separation
independent studies.
Independent studies.
And speaking of independent studies, we're going to be independently studying over the next week. Please join us next week, and please stay cool.
Happy Memorial Day.
Ah, oh, that too.